world barista champion competitor, number 17, Siobhan Lamar Younger, barista champion of the Netherlands. Siobhan, when you're ready, if you raise your hand in the air, that will start your timer. You'll have 15 minutes to present your drinks to the judges. Best of luck. When you're finished, again, raise your hand and that will stop the timer.
Thank you
when
very
you're
much.
Ready.
Thank you. Time. Good day. My name is Siobhan Younger and I'm the barista at Restaurant Ivy in Rotterdam. It is a Michelin-starred restaurant where people come in to have a complete culinary experience, actually. And for me as a barista, it's all about that last part of that experience, the big finale, as I call it. Here I can show my guests what specialty coffee is all about. And that's where we're gonna start with today, the big finale, the amazing coffee experience at my restaurant. So welcome. Where you're gonna get to taste El Salvador. It's from the Santa Ana region, where after picking this coffee, it's sun-dried for about 15 days on clay patios. It's moved and turned every hour the first days, then every second hour for a day, and gradually with longer intervals till the coffee gets more stable. Well, this makes it even more elegant, super sweet, and rich in its berry flavors. So today we're all sharing something, obviously. Today I want you to experience that restaurant feeling, where you can not only ask for a sommelier when you want some advice about wine, but also for a barista when it comes to coffee. So actually I want to show you how we serve specialty coffee and actually take you to that restaurant. So not just to serve you a nice espresso or cappuccino, but actually give you the total experience, what it's all about actually. So imagine you're in a restaurant right now. You're my guest, sitting at the table with the same, actually, table format. You've just had 11 courses meal, and you're ready for coffee right now. So I'm gonna stop talking, but first of all, I have a menu card for you. On the front page, you'll find some more information about this coffee, and on the back side, specific tasting notes. So I'm gonna start with making the cappuccinos, first course starter. The nice smooth flavors of the cappuccinos. You're welcome. Need you 100, need you 100%. I wanna be the one you tell all your friends about. Baby, I'll be the one you just can't do without. You gotta give me everything, baby, and no doubt. Give me 100, need you 100%. Above sea level, this coffee was picked then brought down to El Molino, where the producer is known as to be innovative in ways of producing and farming. Let me get a good look at it. Ooh, so thick. Now I know what they call it, a fatty. And oh, shit, so sick. Gotta hit and pick up a habit. That's all right. You're all mine. Because he's still experimenting with producing naturals after so many years and is still developing new and better techniques to improve his cup. And that's what we all like, to be innovative. You're welcome.
Time to hear some noise for the first set of cappuccinos!
Ivy 2, and by keeping the color of the coffee rather light and stretching the roast development time as long as possible, we kept all the natural sweetness in the cup. The reason why I started with this cappuccino today is first time I had this coffee, it was as a cappuccino too, just like you right now. And I really love the dark chocolate bitter tones and actually that fresh fruity flavors that you taste right through the milk. You're welcome.
Please put your hands together for that second set of cappuccino!
A lovely espresso right here. But first, as you have noticed, I've poured you some natural sparkling water that just neutralizes the tasting, but it's a little extra in between the courses. So in this espresso, you're gonna taste a lot of red fruity flavors like raspberry, pomegranate. It has a deep sweetness, also a clean style, and it's a medium style espresso. Enjoy.
Please put your hands together for the espresso course.
Thank you.
the legend of the phoenix. All ends with beginnings. What keeps the planet spinning? The force from the beginning.
Thank you.
Love. Has no rhythm. Your gift keeps on giving. What is this I'm feeling? If you wanna leave, I'm with it.
We come too far. Last part of the shirt. I was thinking, how can I actually trigger my guests and surprise them with specialty coffee? How can I find that little extra, that edge, where you can actually entertain their tasting buds, but also entertain them visually at the same time? So that's what my signature is about, is adding a little extra and giving my guests an experience. So first of all, I'm gonna actually coat my glass with grated Sterinize. It's gonna give the drink a nice aromatic boost just now. Here I have an 8-hour infusion based on cane sugar. Thank you. Based on cane sugar and the nice sweet flavors of tonka beans. Added a little bit of cocoa leaves in it, some pomegranate and red berries. So the cocoa actually symbolizes the nice bitter tones of the espresso, and the red berries and pomegranate, the sweet acidic style of the espresso. Well, it's liquid now, but I'm gonna turn it into a sorbet with liquid nitrogen. It's minus 196 degrees. And obviously I wanna make a, that was just for the show. I wanna make a chilled drink. And the reason why I don't use ice is because ice melts and it turns into water. And liquid nitrogen, minus 196 degrees. And the nice thing about it is it goes so fast, and on very low temperature, you get eeny meeny ice crystals. So you get a nice smooth structure, but more important, more taste. Actually, it's that same espresso from just now, but this time bring it in a whole other dimension by enhancing the flavors of the espresso. And for me, this is a perfect way to bring down the temperature, where I can then play with a nice aromatic style and the sweet fruity flavors. So the reason why I'm using a wine glass, it's nice, but the wine glass keeps all the aromas of the espresso, sorbet, and also the star anise in the glass. So when you smell it, you get one big boost of aromas. So what I would like you to do right now is add the espresso in the glass. Thank you. Smell it, please. Break the surface by swirling three times. Taste. And enjoy. You're welcome.
Let's hear a big round of applause for the signature beverage.
Mm-hmm.
time.
World Barista Championship competitor number 17, Siobhan Lamar Younger, Barista Champion of the Netherlands. How was that?
That's an experience, man.
That looked a lot of fun.
That's the first time. I'm a bit speechless, I think.
Fantastic. So, I've been told they're going to call you Gio, is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I'm going to drop the whole full title and just call you Gio. So, tell us what was happening with the dry ice and what
it's
was
liquid nitrogen. That. Liquid nitrogen. It's minus 196 degrees, and that's actually a perfect way for me to bring down the temperature of a sorbet of liquid. Because what you got eeny meeny ice crystals, so it's nice and smooth, and you keep your taste of your liquid. So,
I was really intrigued to hear that you work in a restaurant.
This
is unusual.
Yeah,
but we're seeing a few places now starting to take coffee seriously. What is your advice to other restaurants that maybe aren't doing that and should be? Because obviously you guys are taking it seriously.
Yeah, it's actually Chef, he's doing it actually for years now, and it's important because you do everything good, and at the end, it's so.
As coffee people have talked about it for years, you know, that it's always disappointing. You can go out for an amazing meal and have terrible coffee, and it ruins an evening.
Yeah.
So, please, can we put our hands together? A big round of applause for the World Barista Championship competitor number 17, Siobhan Lamar Younger, Barista Champion of the Netherlands.